हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑलिव पॉड। आई होप यू आर ऑल डूइंग वेल और आपकी एग्जाम की तैयारी बहुत अच्छे से चल रही है। दिस वीडियो इज अ सीरीज ऑफ वीडियो थ्रू विच वी आर कवरिंग द 50 मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कंप्यूटर अवेयरनेस क्वेश्चंस। दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ द वीडियो। इफ यू हैव नॉट सीन पार्ट वन, आफ्टर दिस वीडियो एंड्स यू कैन गो check that video out to not miss the important questions. Now this is very important for all the examination of which computer awareness is a section. After this you can also take up a free mock test provided by Olive Board, the link of which is provided in the description box. Now taking a mock test is very important for all banking and government examinations because you know how much time you're allocating to a particular section and how you should go about it. Uska analysis is very important for you to know what is your strength and what is your weaknesses. So the link to take up a free mock test is provided in the description box. So whichever examination you're preparing for, you can go and take up a test. Before we get started with the video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest videos. The first question: which of the following is the process of carrying out commands? So whenever we give a command to the computer, what is the process or through which of the following we can carry out that particular command? So here the correct answer is executing. So it is through executing that we carry out the commands that is given to the computer. The next question: computers use the number system to store data and perform calculation. So it is which number system? What is the correct answer here? The correct answer is option 1, binary. So binary number system is used by the computers, so they understand zeros and ones, right? So it is binary number system. The third question: you can keep your personal file holders in which of the following? So whenever we have to go and store something in the computer as a personal file, where can we store it? The correct answer here is my documents. So we can go there and keep all our personal files. The next question: compared to secondary storage, the primary storage is what? So is it slow or fast? Is it expensive or not so expensive? Here the correct answer is fast and expensive. So when we compare primary storage with secondary storage, the primary storage is very fast and hence it is very expensive also. Which of the following is not the form of secondary storage? So we know there is primary storage, there is secondary storage. So out of the following options, which is not a secondary storage? Here the correct answer is option 1, semiconductor memory, that is a primary memory and not a secondary storage. Sixth question: fifth generation computers are based on what? So out of the following options, what are the fifth generation computers based on? Now on this particular topic we have created a video. If you've not watched it, we are adding it after this video, so you can go watch all the videos in the series to make sure that your basics of computer awareness gets cleared. Here the correct answer is option 1, that is artificial intelligence. The seventh question: a remote batch processing operation where data is solely input to a central computer would require what? So out of the following, which is that would be required? The correct answer here is option 2, simplex lines. The next question: a network geometric arrangement in which a single connecting line is shared by a number of nodes is called. So out of the following, it is a single connecting line through which various nodes are connected or shared. Here the correct answer is option 2, bus topology. Cache memory is a what? So out of the following options, what is the correct answer? Here the correct answer is option 1, that is small buffer storage. So it stores a particular information or data temporarily as a buffer storage. So it works between CPU and the main memory of the computer. The next question, cache memory is what? Is it smaller or bigger than the main memory, or is it slower or faster than the main memory? Here, the correct answer is it is smaller and faster than the main storage. So, though it is small in nature, but it is very fast to get data out of cache memory, is very fast. Which of the following is a non-volatile memory? So, out of the following options, there are some that are volatile memory, but which is the one that is non-volatile? The correct answer is ROM, which is read-only memory. The next question, what can be programmed one time by either the manufacturer or the computer user? So, we can program it only once. Once programmed, it cannot be modified. So, what is it that can be programmed only once and cannot be modified after that? The correct answer is PROM, which is programmable read-only memory. Which of the following terms applies to communication between two computer systems? So, what is it that is applied to communication between two computer systems? The correct answer is option 4, connectivity. The next question, a memory in CPU or central processing unit that holds program instructions, input data, intermediate results, and the output information produced during the processing is what is the memory? The correct answer is option 2, that is primary memory, that stores or holds all the instructions, input data, output information, intermediate results, etc. Snowball is what? So, out of the following options, what does snowball indicate? The correct answer is option 4, that is both A and B. That means it is string-oriented symbolic language, which is a very high-level language. The next question, speech recognition is what? So, as we know that speech recognition is very much in news, so there is a probability of this being asked in the examination. So, here the correct answer is option 1, which is the ability to input data directly into a computer system by speaking to it. So, if we talk about iPhones, we have Siri, through which we can guide or we can speak to Siri and get our instructions done or anything processed through it. So, we can tell it directly by speaking to it. An assembler is a what? So, out of the following, what is an assembler? The correct answer is option 1, that is a translator. So, an assembler is a translator. The next question, in a disk system, time required for a record to be read or written is stored in. Here, the correct answer is option 4, that is seek time, which is the time required for a record to be read or written. Auxiliary storage is what? So, out of the following options, what is auxiliary storage? The correct answer is option 1, that is secondary storage. So, secondary storage is also known as auxiliary storage. Archive is what? So, when we use any social media, like when we talk about WhatsApp also, if we want to delete a chat, so they say that instead of deleting, we can archive it or archive it. What is the correct answer? It is option 1, that is backup storage. A device mounted on a communication satellite which receives, amplifies and retransmits signals from Earth station is called what? So, out of the following, what is the correct answer? It is mounted on a communication satellite. The correct answer is option 4, transponder. So, it receives, amplifies and retransmits signals from Earth stations. The next question, technique of using disk space to make programs believe that system contains more random access memory than is actually available is called what? So it is sort of a temporary memory that we try to create to show that RAM contains more memory. It is option one, that is virtual memory. A sequence of instruction, which is a software that is substituted for a hardware and stored in read-only memory, is called what? So out of the following, what is the correct answer? It is option 2, that is firmware. The next question is ANSI is what? So out of the following options, what is the correct answer for ANSI? It is option 3, which is both A and B, which means ANSI stands for American National Standards Institute, which is a USA or America based national organization that establishes uniform standards in several fields of computers. A pictorial representation that uses predefined symbols to describe either a logic of a computer program or the data flow and processing steps of a system is referred to as what? So out of the following option, what is the correct answer? It is option 1, that is flowchart. That's all we have for you in this video. I hope you like the video. Do share it with your friends who are also preparing for bank and government examinations. If you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe now to not miss any videos from us. All the very best for your exam preparations. Thank you.